Hey everybody, Captain Kimo here, and I have a new video for you. This one is not a video tutorial, more of an overview of my new action. And you can get this action at my website at hdrworkshop.com. So what's this Photoshop action all about? Well, it's really something I did for fun, but it came out really cool. So this is an action on basically post-processing mushrooms. I like shooting mushrooms, and I know a lot of people like doing the same thing. And mushrooms are just very neat to shoot. So I created this action in Photoshop to post-process this mushroom to make it look even cooler. Here is the this is the original mushroom photo, and this is the processed version using the action that I created. All right, so let's take a look at another example. This is another mushroom that I shot. This is the post-process version, and this is the original version. So after I run the action, the mushroom photo will look like this. Okay, so let's go back to the previous photo here, and let's go ahead and break down everything, all the layers here, to show you what this action does, and this way you can reproduce it without using the action. It's actually very simple. It only has five layers. So the first layer is a denoise layer, because when I'm shooting mushrooms, I'm usually shooting at 1600 ISO. Anything where I'm shooting just stock still images, stuff for fun, I really shoot high ISO so I can get the speed, so I can just stop everything. I don't want anything blurry, so I shoot as fast as possible. And next, I will unsharpen the image. So after I do the denoise, I'll just unsharpen it a little bit, or sharpen it using the unsharpen tool, and then I'll run Topaz Adjust and make the image a lot more vibrant. And then I'll run a little Orton effect, and then shadow highlight. So let's go ahead and go over that real fast again, and show you what happens here. So I'll do the denoise. Let's go ahead and zoom in here, and you can see there's some noise here. You might not be able to see it in this video, but there's some grain there. So if I run denoise, it will remove the grain. So let's go ahead and see that right there. So it'll remove the grain, and then the unsharpen layer here, it'll sharpen up the image by using the unsharp tool. So let me zoom in, or zoom out, then zoom back in, and you can see how it just unsharpens it a tad, not a lot. And then the layer will be the topaz. Let me go zoom out real fast. The topaz adjust, and this really is what does the most impact to the photo. And then we have the Orton effect, which then deepens the color and then gives it a little bit of a dreamy effect. And I think that works very well with mushrooms. And then next, we have shadow highlights. And then that just pulls back some of the fill color, or some of the detail in the shadows here. And we have our final image. Alright, so let's go ahead and go back to the original mushroom photo here, and we're just going to go ahead and reproduce the whole thing. The first thing I'll do is I'll select the background layer. I'll hit Control J, Command J on a Mac, and we will duplicate this layer, and I will do the denoise. So we'll go into Filters, and we'll run a quick Topaz denoise. We'll use the denoise right here. And I use the JPEG Strong, so it's nothing fancy. Just hit the Strong and then hit OK. Okay, so after denoise, we will go ahead and duplicate that layer again, and we will go into the filters, and we just into the sharpen, unsharp mask, and this will sharpen our image a little bit. So we will go ahead and let me zoom out here. I'll zoom out, and then I'll zoom back in into the bark here, so I can get a better view of how much unsharpening I want, or sharpening I want. And I'll just play around. I think maybe 100, about. That looks like enough. So this is about 127 at 3.3, and I'll hit OK. And then we'll duplicate the layer again. And now we're going to run Topaz Adjust. I'm going to go into Filters here and go in Topaz Labs into the Topaz Adjust 5, and I will launch that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with one of the presets, and that is Brilliant Warm. And already you can see it's looking pretty nice. So I'm going to go ahead and just bring down the adaptive exposure a little, and just bring down the contrast a tad. And now I'm going to go into the finishing touches and go into the warmth and bump the warmth up a little bit. And close that and just add a little dark vignette around the whole photo. Just to kind of draw the eye towards the mushrooms a little bit. And hit OK. Now we're almost done, and I am going to go ahead and duplicate that layer again, and I am going to create a little soft light. But before I do that, I'm going to go ahead and this is going to be the Orton effect. I'm going to go into filters and use the Topaz Labs lens effect. Again, I'm going to use another preset. It's going to be Canon 135 f2. I'm just going to click on that and hit OK, and this will blur our image. Once we applied the lens effect, we'll go ahead and go into the mode and change it to soft light, and this will give us a dreamy effect. This is what we call the Orton effect, and I will bring down the opacity down by 50%, and so this is the before, and then this is after, a little more dreamy, a little more rich in color. Then I'm going to hit Control Shift Alt E, and this takes all my layers below me and creates a new layer, one solid layer on top. Next, I will go ahead and run our final process here and go into the Adjust Shadow Highlights. And now we're going to play around with the settings here to bring back the fill color. If I go, this is before here, so this is after playing around with the settings. So I'm just going to play around with the settings and adjust them to bring out some of the darkness there. And the darkness is coming from some of our processing, so I'm just going to bring out some detail in the shadows. And that looks good. I'm going to hit OK. Alright, so this is the final image with the shadow highlights. If I were to click the eyeball tool off there, you'll see the photo with the Orton effect, and then we bring out some of the detail in the shadows using the shadow highlights. Okay, so that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you have fun with this action, and send me some photos if you want. I'd love to see them. Until next time, this is Captain Kimo signing out.